Before we continue with the rest of the video, we could use your help. Click that like button to help spread the word about Watch JoJo, and also be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. Hikers found this horse alone in the woods. Then they looked at his face and realized. Twigs snapped underfoot and leaves brushed their heads as the walkers made their way through the woods. To them, it seemed like another perfectly normal hike. That is until the ramblers saw something jostle for their attention near a tree. And that something turned out to be a local social media celebrity. Play-Doh belonged to Susan Crawford of York, Pennsylvania, who loves spending time with her favorite 10-year-old horse. However, in May of 2016, Play-Doh became separated from his rider and went missing. Understandably, Crawford was devastated. The event actually took place on May 27, 2016. Crawford, a passionate horse rider and member of the League of Maryland Horsemen Equestrian Club, was simply following a trail with a friend in Patapsco State Park. Play-Doh, however, slipped on difficult terrain and slid down a steep bank, tossing Crawford in the fall. "We slipped down and I slid off him," she said in an interview with news site WJC. "Then he took off. He got spooked and took off." Crawford was shook up and confused, but otherwise uninjured. Play-Doh, however, was nowhere to be found. He had his tack and saddle on with a lime green holster and breast collar. Crawford told the Baltimore Sun, "We were close to the tunnel on the tracks. He ran along the tracks toward a parking lot, and a couple saw him head right up into the woods." Fortunately, a large search party was formed to look for Play-Doh the very same day. Indeed, Howard County Police, mountain bikers, hikers, Maryland State Police, and members of Crawford's Equestrian Club scoured the woods. Despite the turnout and Play-Doh's distinctive riding gear, though, it seemed like the horse had just vanished. It was hard to understand how he could have vanished or that no one had seen him or found any of his tack, Crawford said in an interview. She also described the situation as like being trapped in a nightmare. But despite fearing the worst, she was determined to do everything she could for Play-Doh. "I tried to come to terms with the worst-case scenarios. He was hurt, he had been taken, he'd been hit by a car. Trying to face the worst helped me put those thoughts aside and focus on doing everything I could to find him," Crawford said. However, she did have one last shot to get her horse back. And so it was that she set up a Facebook page called Where's Play-Doh and uploaded pictures and details about her missing pride and joy. Luckily, the campaign took off. "We had over 10,000 shares of Play-Doh's story," she said. The movement even reached the local evening news. Her equestrian group was a big help too. Hundreds of posters were hung and the League of Maryland Horsemen, where we were staying, turned their campground into a base camp, she said. Moreover, it seemed that the campaign was a success when Crawford finally got a call from someone who said that they'd seen Play-Doh. Unfortunately, the call was a bust. "We got there and it wasn't him," she told CBS Baltimore. Now time was getting short. After all, Play-Doh's riding gear may have gotten caught in branches and trapped the horse. Or so thought League of Maryland Horsemen member Vicki Sadler. Then, after nearly 2 weeks of constant searching, three hikers stumbled on a horse in the woods matching Play-Doh's description exactly. The hikers were David Sugar, Emily Perryman, and Vlad Kostantinov, and they were on a nature hike throughout the area when they noticed one of Crawford's posters at the beginning of their trail. The hikers hadn't otherwise heard the news of Play-Doh and made light of the situation. "We kind of joked about it. How do you lose a horse?" one of the group said in an interview with CBS Baltimore. Certainly, they didn't expect to find the local celebrity. However, that's exactly what they did, and the equestrians group's concerns turned out to be warranted. Yes, the hikers found Play-Doh's gear tangled around his leg and restricting his movement. The horse was there, the saddle was kind of cockeyed 90 degrees, one of the hikers told CBS Baltimore. Naturally, then, the group freed Play-Doh and took him to a nearby inn. In fact, Play-Doh had made quite the journey. After bucking his owner near Marriottsville Road, he traveled south in the direction of the train tracks in panic. Sugar, Perryman, and Kostantinov found the horse all tuckered out and ready for rescue close to Woodstock Road. Crawford was overjoyed. There were definitely moments when she wondered whether she'd ever see her beloved horse again. So she and her fellow equestrian club members went to meet Play-Doh as soon as possible, and they loaded him onto a horse trailer to take him back to their campsite. A veterinarian at the camp then checked Play-Doh's condition. Fortunately, aside from a few minor lacerations, a single deep cut, and a long face, the horse was in relatively good health. He had a bunch of other little rubs from the tack, but otherwise he didn't look skinny, Crawford reported. Yet, while the vet gave Play-Doh what little treatment he needed, it mostly just seemed like he missed his human. he kind of put his head on my shoulder, and he was like, "Oh, thank God, Mom found me," Crawford told CBS Baltimore. He obviously was very glad to have someone come help him when he needed it, she added, and everyone involved in the search for Plato was ecstatic to have found him safe and sound too. In fact, upon Plato's arrival back home, he received a huge horsey welcome party. In August 2016, 3 months after being found, Plato even got to express his gratitude personally to the people who found him. "We were very happy to visit with Plato, Susan, and her friends," one of the rescuers wrote on Facebook. "It's nice to see that he's doing well and fully recovered from his escapade." In consideration of all the events that led to Plato's return, Crawford is now a steadfast advocate of social media when it comes to finding lost animals. Of course, the advantage of getting more people aware of a missing animal is in hastening the likelihood of finding the missing party. "It really is overwhelming. You just don't know how you're going to go about thanking everybody for what they did," Crawford explained to the Baltimore Sun. "The people who walked, hiked, or drove around to find him, who flew drones or cooked food for us and brought food over, it was just so overwhelming." The happy horse was expected to make a full recovery from his ordeal. Still, he did have to take things slow at first. However, Plato's human expressed her joy on social media when the horse's two doctors gave him the green light to get back to his regular way of life again. A big thank you to the Green Glen the only honor. The event also raises money for two charities that are important to many people's hearts. Canter for the Cause funds the Thoroughbred Aftercare Alliance that retires, rehomes, and retrains thoroughbred horses. It also provides support for the Susan G. Komen Maryland organization and its fight against breast cancer. So while Plato might have lost his way for a while, it now seems that he truly is back on track. Please don't forget to click on the button if you like the video, and share this video with your friends below. Please don't forget to subscribe and activate the bell to receive everything that's new.